So another example of year-round programming that Rebels North offers is called the Band of Fools, which is my favorite name for any of our programs.
Good, I'm glad.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
That's great. So the Band of Fools is another opportunity for, it's a come as you are kind of program. Mm-hmm. It's an instrumental ensemble that would imply that you need to play an instrument to join. I would argue that you don't necessarily need to play an instrument to join. Really, the goal is to see who walks in the door, put something in their hands, mm-hmm. and create some instrumental music. Now we always have some melody players, fiddlers, or recorder players, mm-hmm. whistle players. The last Band of Fools session, we had someone playing the English concertina.
Right. Uh-huh. So,
if the concertina is an unfamiliar instrument to you, it's a squeeze box, like mm-hmm. an accordion, with a higher kind of reedier sound and no piano keyboard. Mm-hmm. I'm waiting for the day when we have a tuba player walk in the door for Band of Fools. I would receive that person enthusiastically. Really, the whole point and premise of the Band of Fools is that we don't need written music. Mm-hmm. We don't even need to know who we're going to get. Mm-hmm. Whoever walks in the door, we're gonna create music together, mm-hmm. And it's been really fun.
The one that I went to, there were a few chord charts that were available. Mm-hmm. Some pretty simple chords.
Yep.
I play guitar,
right?
And like the D A G, pretty simple. So even a beginning guitar player could hang in there and get this. But it sounds like even sometimes you are able to do this without sheet music?
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow. Okay.
So a lot of it is aiming to teach things by ear.
Mm, okay.
One of the other commitments, I co-lead the Band of Fools with Pat McPherson, mm-hmm. Who's a great fiddler. Mm-hmm. And music educator. She and I like to teach things and learn things by ear, so we'll always start there, not knowing session to session what range of ability we're going to have.
Yeah.
We're also committed to making sure that people like you, who do have a little bit more of a repertoire of mm-hmm. chords from which to draw than a more beginning guitar player, will actually have some chord charts to work mm-hmm. from.
The one that I went to, I think there were about 10 or 12 people who mm-hmm. showed up.
Yep.
Many not having met before. Mm-hmm. They were able to participate for free.
Yep.
And then I think we played for about 2 hours?
Yeah.
Something like that?
About that.
And then, so then what happens after that? This is where I think it really gets fun.
Yeah. So we, after we have our Band of Fools, sometimes we call it a jam session, sometimes we call it a workshop. It's a little bit of a mix of both. Mm-hmm. We like to try and keep it moving. But there is a goal of developing a repertoire that will allow us to move into the big hall at Tracy Hall mm-hmm. and play for a community dance.
Okay, so the community dance, I mean, this sounds pretty impressive because we've first taken some musicians, you didn't know who was going to show up, mm-hmm. you didn't know what you were going to play necessarily, and then a couple hours later, everybody is playing a dance, and I now was part of it, and we did. It was great.
Right, right.
Yeah. And the dancers who showed up, it was promoted, they're almost promoted as two separate events,
right.
but they're truly interconnected in this way.
Absolutely.
And so people who are just interested in showing up for the dance, they arrive, I think they showed up at 6:30, mm-hmm. and then tell me about the dance and how that went.
Right, the community dances are another opportunity for people to come together mm-hmm. and socialize
yep.
with dancing attached. In addition to my other more musical roles with, with Rebels North. I'm also a dance caller. Mm-hmm. And so I lead the community dances by choosing dance repertoire that draws from certainly a American traditional dance, like square dancing, mm-hmm. Big circle dances, mm-hmm. Dances from the Appalachian region, but also casts a wider net culturally. So we'll do dances from, we've got some Danish folk dances that we do that are really, really easy and fun to do, easy to teach. I'm often out on the floor with the dancers, sometimes holding a microphone, sometimes just using my loud voice. Really, the goal with the dances is making sure that everyone that wants to be out on the dance floor feels like they can be there and do the dance without having to think about it. That's always my goal. I don't want people to think when they're in a community dance. Their job is just to move. It's my job to think.
And yeah, these dances are nice ways for a range of ages to get together.
Yeah, absolutely.
Families show up. Yep. And you know, kids will be like dancing face to face with a senior that they've never met before. So again, it's a nice way for different generations to connect.
Absolutely.
And like we were saying from the beginning, the musicians also are maybe unfamiliar to the dancers, and so they just have this moment together.
Right. And, I think one of the really neat things about the Band of Fools community dance model, as you observed before, they are two kind of separate programs that have this moment of convergence. Mm-hmm. Any community dance that has live music is a really it's a really exciting thing. I mean, how often do you go dance to a live band of members of your own community?
Absolutely.
So it's I think it's a unique thing that we offer opportunities to participate really across the board. And if you decide that you're playing in the band and you'd rather be out on the dance floor, there is nobody stopping you. So
well, we have a Band of Fools and community dance combo actually at the Balloon Festival coming up. That'll be on Sunday, the Sunday, May 20th, day two of the Balloon Festival.
Yeah, right around 10 o'clock, I think we'll probably do that.
And then I think we'll have another one at the end of August at the Pavilion in East Thetford.
Yes, which is a beautiful space on Pavilion Road there, just down from Cedar Circle Farm. Mm-hmm.
And then most of the rest of them happen at Tracy Hall in Norwich.
Yep.
So, if you want to, again, follow us on Facebook, keep an eye on our website, join our newsletter, you can stay posted on when the Band of Fools and the community dance happen.